Guys, look at here. This is my machine. So I can able to access this machine in my virtual machine with the PuTTY. So I'm using PuTTY. Some people having a problem with the PuTTY also. So I will tell. No. What I'm doing? Yeah, here it is. Print. Okay, so you have a system and that is in your VMware system, right? And you got a problem with your physical network access kind of stuff. So normally I connected like this with a VMnet 0. I'm accessing my virtual machine using PuTTY like this. If in case you got a problem like this, you can put it like a VMnet 0. So for some people it is not working. You can use NAT also, okay? Either use VMnet 0 or a NAT, okay? People who are not able to work with VMnet 0, people who are using a NAT, so NAT we can't use with a PuTTY, okay? PuTTY access may be difficult, okay? You may not able to access with the PuTTY for your Linux. Okay, so what you will do, install GUI mod. Okay, install GUI. Install GUI. So 1 GB or 2 GB, 1 GB RAM or 2 GB RAM for a machine. Okay, you can use it, no problem. Okay, for most of the practical, only very few practicals required a compulsory 2 virtual machines. Okay, most of the practicals, we don't require 2 machines. So 2 machine practicals, do it in 2 machines. 1 machine practical, do it in a 1 machine only. Understand? So guys, what I'm doing here, I have a Linux PC currently. One Linux PC currently I'm accessing with a PuTTY. This is my Linux machine. One Linux machine. I'm accessing this Linux machine using PuTTY. So I check my IP address. Currently my IP address is 192.168.0.170. Okay. It dynamically came from my router. We all know how to do it. Okay. Yeah, already I saved my settings in PuTTY. So which we know already. So this is my IP address already there in my already saved 170, same thing, same IP address as a Linux. Just open. Guys, some of practicals you can do as a root, some of you can able to with a student, some are pseudo users. Okay, so disk management kind of stuff, better login as a root and do it instead of a pseudo or anything. For some people, already Python is there, right? Already Python is started. Just look at Python, C, C++, Java, Linux, any command line type, okay, where you things you usually type, okay? Whenever you got a free time, means any time, like a weekly once at least, go and touch it, go and practice on it, so you won't forget. Yes, everybody can able to hear, right? Able to see and hear?
Yes.
Yes, very good. Yeah, YouTube recording is there. No, that is there. Suhas present. So only one waiting person. Suhas. So 10, everybody is there. Okay, so look at here. If in case full day, 2 days classes, means you may get a time to practice. Okay, so what you will do? So you can practice anytime. It's not overall practice. Explanation will take time, but practice won't take time. Okay, the explanation may take a time to explain one by one thing, but practice usually won't take time. The first one we will see is a disk management. First we will see the disk management. Guys, whenever we install a Linux machine, that time I select a disk, I choose a disk by standard partitions, not a LVM partitions. Why I selected a standard partition and why I took a very big hard disk like a 200 GB, I took it even though it is not required, 20 GB enough, but I took a 200 GB. And out of 200 GB, so 30 GB or 40 GB or 100 GB, free space is also available. Why I keep that free space? Why can't you use it for another thing? Because of practicing disk management purpose only. Okay, if you remember how you install a Linux, that time I given a space for a slash. Before slash, what I given? Slash boot, slash, slash home, and a swap. So we given a certain space, like this is for a 1 GB, and a slash boot, slash EFI. I given another 1 GB for it, 20 GB, 20 GB, 4 GB or 2 GB, like that I given, okay? Or a 40 GB, a 20 GB, 2 GB, 1 GB, 1 GB, or like that I've given. Even though I didn't cross much in a 100 GB also. Lot of space is available. Okay, I took a 200 GB, lot of space is available, even though I space paid for that. Why I keep that space? Why I keep that space? For practicing disk management purpose only. Okay, remember that one. Guys, first of all, commands are easy. Commands are very easy. Okay, to do it. Very simple. Only one or two times you do it, you will do it. But what we are doing is very important. The steps in the disk management compulsory lesson. So when we started a class, the first day itself, I told every hardware related things as a file stores in slash dev. Your hard disk name is, it look like SDA. Already I told SDA means, in a SDA, D means disk. So when you see a D, it is a hard disk. First of all, it is a hard disk. Okay, disk, storage disk. A means first disk. Okay. B means, if in case, if you see a B, A, B, like that. SDA, SDB, kind of stuff. SDC. Okay. B means second. C means third disk. Okay. For example, you see like this, A1. A1 means, so first disk, A means first disk and first partition. First disk, first partition. What is A2? A means first disk, second partition. What is A3? Same thing, third partition. Okay, so it is like that. Okay, so it is like a SDA1, SDA2, SDA3, like this. Guys, the whole disk, we call it as a SDA, but S is represented different way. So sometimes SDA, sometimes different way. So that is also will tell, but I will try to explain this one once. See, the first disk is SDA, second disk SDB, second, third disk SDC, like that. I have a one disk, so that is SDA. And there is a partitions, different partitions are there. Okay. And this is a GPT type of disk it is. Okay, so we'll see that one. This is the first partition. name of the first partition is SDA1, second partition SDA2, third partition SDA3, SDA4, SDA5, SDA6, like that. How many partitions you created? Okay, then those many names you will get it. Next, already in our days, these are given for slash board, slash, okay, slash home. Okay, so these are given for this one. Guys, again, look at here. This is my Windows system. C drive, D drive, E drive, F drive. These are all partitions. I want to access the data from F drive. Open the F drive. Look at the data. You can access the data, right? So directly you can open the particular drive by drive letter and you can access it. Maybe like you got a doubt, like you can see, I want to access the data in a H drive. This is H drive. Like this also, you can access it. Okay. So there is a drive letter, and the drive through drive letter, we can able to access it. In Linux, we don't have a drives. We don't have a drive letters mainly. We don't have a drive letters. Okay, so remember that one. So we don't have a drives, we don't have a drive letters. Then how to put a data in it? Okay, this is existing hard disk and I want to create a new partition. Anyway, we know the commands, so we learn the commands, and I created a new partition, SDA5. I created a new partition is SDA5. Okay. Okay, so I created a new partition SDA5. For example, it is maybe a 10 GB. Think, okay, think like it is. I created a 10 GB partition. The partition automatical name is SDA5 from here slash dev slash SDA5. Now I want to put a data in this particular drive. In this particular drive, I want to put a data. So what is the full name of this one? Is always written like a slash dev slash SDA5. Just this partition only I've written here, so I didn't do anything. Just this is the same thing, just for a separately I'm written here. Okay, I separately I kept it slash dev slash SDA5. Okay. Same thing, this is the partition slash dev slash SDA is a disk, and partition is SDA1, SDA2, SDA3, like that. This is a new partition I created. It is a 10 GB. So this is a 10 GB partition I created, but you cannot put a data in it. You cannot put any data in it because of it is unlike your Windows. There is a no drive letters. Okay. So we have a Windows. In a Windows, we have a drive letters. Access the drives and you can put a data. Okay, accessing the drives, you can put a data in it. Okay, but in a Linux, we can't do it. So what to do? We have to create a folder. We have to create a folder. For example, I create a folder name is my data or a disk 5. It's a folder, guys. So when you say disk 5 means we can create. So okay, D disk. Okay, so when you see disk 5 means again it is it is a disk. No, it is like just a name only. Okay, it is a nothing but a my directory or a folder. I create a directory. My directory name is D disk 5 for understanding. Okay, D disk 5. Now I created a empty folder. This is a empty folder, not a something. You have to take empty. So that's why freshly have to create when you are practicing. Freshly have to create. Okay, empty disk, empty directory. Now we have to mount it to this one. Okay, what we call that one? Mount. Mount means just connection. Mount means connecting. Connecting. Okay. So we have to mount this folder to this drive. Then we can able to put a data in it. Okay. So what are the data is there? So you have to put the data into this particular folder. Okay. You can put a data into this folder. Data goes to this drive. Data goes to this drive. So this is the practical we are going to do it. So what we are going to do it actually, we create a partition first. Okay, we'll take some other color for a separate. First of all, I'm going to create a partition. Okay, first of all, I have to create a partition. Next, I have to create a folder. Next, mount it. Mount it to our partition. Mount the folder to our partition and put some data in this one. Put the data into that one and unmount it. Okay, unmount. Unmount means remove this connection and verify. Okay, like that. So there is a few verifications are there. So that is also we'll see by directly command. But understand the first part of practical is create a partition is important. First, guys, remember first step. Create a partition. Create a partition and get the name. What is the name? It is get the name. Okay, that is the first one. What is the first one? Create a partition. What is the name? Next, create a directory. Create a directory. So that is the second one. Guys, anybody will tell this answer at least. You know, I created a fresh hard disk. I created a fresh partition. Not a hard disk. I created a fresh partition. New partition created. Okay, just it's a new partition from the disk management. In Windows disk management, I create a new partition. Okay, fresh partition. Just I said 10 GB. Okay. If I want to put a data in this one, what to do? In Windows, just you shrink the volume.
Format.
Very good. Ready answer, right? Very good. Format. You have to format with a certain file system, right? So in Windows, we have a FAT and NTFS, right? FAT and NTFS type of file system, we can use it. In Linux, we use ext3 or ext4. I'm using ext4 here, okay? Or XFS, anything we can use it. In Linux, we use ext3 or ext4 or XFS, like that. I'm using ext4 because I'm using 7 version. ext4 is supporting. This is the latest one anyway. Okay, I have to check it with 8 also, but ext4 is there in market. Okay, first, create a partition. Okay, and first create a partition. Second one is format. Third one is directory. So this is the first one. Format is second one. Third one is create a directory. Fourth one is mounting. Mount it. Okay. Then you have to check it. Fourth one is mounting. The practical is completed. Next is verification. You can use a command like a df command. Okay. Fifth one is verification. Df. Using a df, mounted or not. Put some data in it. Okay. Disconnecting it, verifying it, like that. The sixth one is FS tab. What is FS tab? Like that we can see. Guys, this mount is temporary mount. If you restart your computer, it will be unmount automatically. Okay, every time you have to mount manually. You want a permanent mounting, you have to use FS tab. That we will see, okay, once we completed this part. Okay. Next, what we missing here, that is S is there, no? That is also I will tell. The S means, sorry, S represent SCSI type of disk. S represent SCSI type of disk. H represent normal IDE. IDE or SATA, PATA, everything is same, okay? IDE means this is like a basic structure, okay? So IDE means any hard disk, okay? Normally anything you can say hard disk. ID type or SATA type or PATA type, it is ID type hard disk only. Next, V means virtual disk, okay? Virtual hard disk. Virtual disk means virtual hard disk. So which is look like this, and so you can see SDA, SDB like this. This is HDA, HDB like this. VDA. Okay, sorry. VDA. VDB. So VHDA, habituated, okay. VDC like that. Okay. Names are like that. So when you see first letter, S means it's a SCSI, H means normal regular hard disk, okay, V means virtual hard disk, okay. Virtual hard disk, the things are there. Okay, so first we'll do this practical. One by one commands, we'll tell. Okay, the command we use, fdisk. Okay, so we use the fdisk command to do partitioning. So this is the picture. Guys, understood how what we are going to do? Disk management. Next one is, what is the process? Step by step. Okay, you guys, if you are able to speak, no problem. Put it in a chat box also. At least you are understand, not understand. You want to repeat also, okay?
Sir, mount is like a zip file, sir. It's it will reduce the size then. So
No. Zip, yeah, very good. Zip is to pack, like I have a zip or a archive. Usually zip for compress and archive type. Means I have a certain files. I will keep all these files into one single file as a zip file, like a. So you can see rightly, it is taking a lot of time to display thing. Yeah, my system is slow. So you can see, you can compress into like this. Add to archive, add to desktop.ar, okay, compress to R like this. This is archiving, or a zipping. Send it to compressed zip folder. It means compress and put it in a folder or archive the folder. That is, you have a multiple files, put it in a single file. That is zipping or archiving, RAR, WinRAR, TAR kind of stuff. Mounting means connecting, just like a creating a shortcut, for example, just for example. Okay, this is a folder. This is a folder, but actually data in this folder, not in this folder. It is location is F drive. See, this is the data. It is actually in a F drive. This is called a mounting. Mounting means actually creating a shortcut or a linking. Linking to your one to another one. So here we are linking a drive to a folder. Okay?
Okay.
So that's the difference. Good question. Okay, now,
if you want to create a disk partition, we need to know the disk space availability. How do we check the disk space?
Yes, very good. That's first of all, you want to create a partition. It means unallocated partition must be there, right? You know, Windows unallocated partition kind of stuff, right? So first, unallocated partition should be there. So first of all, we should check that one only. So command is fdisk -cul Or iPhone L is also okay. No problem. No need to put all the CUL kind of stuff. Just L is also okay. Slash dev. Sorry. First of all, do you know your disk name? We don't know, right? Just for example, we don't know. Yeah. We got some server. We don't know about anything about that server. Okay, no space, nothing. How much it is there, we don't know. The name of the disk also, we don't know. So I want to verify. Slash dev. Okay. Guys, tell me this answer. It can be S. It can be S or H or V. Or it can be A or it can be B or it can be a C. Okay. So which one is common? Which one is common? D is common. Before D, there is a character. After D, there is a character. I want to display any character before D and after D. Any character before D and after D. Under slash dev folder.
Find slash hyphen n.
You're trying to find it. That's a good one. Okay. You're trying to find the one. Here it is. It will display a lot of things. Like you can see, it's displaying so many things. Okay. The content here. Okay. This is also having like this. I want only these parts. Like this only should be displayed. Like this. You got? Like this, see? So five partitions, SDA1, SDA2, SDA3, SDA4, SDA5. Five partitions already created. First partition, second, third, fourth, fifth. Five partitions already created. Otherwise, you can put a star also. Okay? Star means, you see, SDA1, SDA2, SDA3, SDA4, SDA, like that it is also showing here. So this represent any. That FD means floppy disk, don't worry. Okay. So I don't know it is SDA or HDA or VDA. So I'm checking this. And I want to check how many partitions, maximum partitions, not more than 10 anyway. So like this, or maybe you can put a star also, no problem. If you want, you can put a star also, no problem. So you can see SDA1, SDA2, SDA3, SDA4, SDA also we can see. See, SDA is a main disk. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is a partitions of the disk. Next. We can also verify fdisk-l or CUL something, you can put it. Slash dev SDA. If you don't give this one also, no problem. Fdisk space -l or -cul. Okay, enter. You'll get the information. See, I will put a big screen. Someone came again. Suhasan. SDA. Yeah, mount is like you're putting a DVD into DVD drive in Windows. So it is any different in Linux. Yeah, it is like that only. Almost like that only. Like that only. Mount is like a connecting. Like a tube. Okay. Yeah, it's like that. It's, you're mounting. Okay. Okay, see here it is. Fdisk space -l. This is another command. Fdisk space -l. Okay. Fdisk GPT support is currently new and there is a new exponent in this. Like this is GPT disk anyway. See, mine is. My disk size is like the SDA. I don't have any other disk. That's why it is showing only one disk name, SDA. Okay, this is a total disk based on a byte size. This is number of sectors, sector units in the sector wise. Okay, each sector size is 512 bytes. It is a GPT type of hard disk. GPT type of hard disk. And I have a partitions like this. First partition, second partition, third partition. Like a few partitions are there. 1, 1 GB, second one is 1 GB, 40 GB, 20 GB, 2 GB for a swap I given. Okay. Just understand what to put a command to know what are the disks you have. That is, you have disk space hyphen L. Next, I know the disk. SDA. Now I want to see for the particular hard disk. Particular hard disk. This means you can put it like this. These are the sectors. These are the sectors. Sector, starting sector, end sector. And see, if you see, after end, next number is coming here. Next number, sectors. Again, you have to go to hardware part. No, 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 I don't want to go. Okay, next. I want to edit this one. So, guys, look at from here. So, what I done, first command I given. So, fdisk is used to, okay, disk partitioning. Okay. So first command I use ls space dev. I want to know what type of disk are there. I like that I want to put it. So like this, I verified directly. Okay. Like this, or you can use a star like this. Any combinations you can use it. That is completely depends on. Next, I use fdisk command space hyphen l to know how many disks are there, how many partitions in the disk. Complete list, complete names, I will get it. Next one I use, hyphen space, hyphen L, slash F slash, SDA, directly know what is the disk name. Next one, I'm not using any FL kind of stuff. L is not using, directly I'm putting slash dev slash SDA. I want to partition the disk, so I'm going inside the disk. Fdisk space slash dev slash SDA. Guys, carefully, one by one step. Look at here. I will show it to you again, no problem. Okay. So fdisk slash dev slash SDA. Now we've inside. Okay. It is showing something. Just read it once if you want. Okay. So fdisk utility. Fdisk utility on the slash dev slash SDA. You don't know what are the commands we use it. So you have to press M for help. I'm pressing M, help. So this is the list I'm getting. So what to do? Copy it. Because we need these things. And I put like this. Okay. I press M. So what I've done first, I press M, I got a menu. This is menu. Here, what are the important things? First of all, we have to verify, do it, verify. Always remember in a Linux, verify, do it, verify. Okay, that is always important. So you can use a P for a print the partition table, print the partition table, P. V is any space is left over, any space is there. Okay, unallocated space is there. You want to know, verify. P for a print the partition table. Okay. If it is there, N. Creating a new partition. Creating a new partition, N. And remaining is you can follow like that. Next. Next, P. V. Next, we important one is P. Sorry. P. L. V, E, like this. You have to follow this sequence. Next, last one is anyway W. Okay. So D, occasionally we use it like this. W for save. Saving your disk partition information. Okay. T is a partition system ID. V for verification of partition table. Okay. What is D? It's a delete the partition. You don't want the partition, you can delete it also. Okay, you can delete the partition also. List a known partition types. List a known partition type. Okay. Print this menu. Remember, follow the sequence, you will understand. Important one is PVNW. Okay, so again I will put it again. So first one is print the partition table, next verify the partition table, next N, create a new partition. Of course, in that one we have to use sizes and all, so we have to do something like that. Next, again print the partition table, verify the partition table, save the partition table. Extra are like a D, E, L. Okay, so if you want to change something, these are important. You want to delete, this is for a deleting purpose. Yeah, this is the menu, you can check it. What I have written here, check it here. Okay, and no need to write again and again. Okay, next. So what I said, guys, first one is what to press first? P. This is the partition table. 5 partitions are created. So total space is almost 200 GB, and totally these many I created. Next.
Verify P.
V. This is 5 out of 128 partitions. Because it's a GPT, 128 partitions you can able to create it. Next, this is the free available. Okay, the total of these free sectors are available, means free space is there. Free space is there. You have to this into 512 bytes, then you will get a how much free space is available. Okay, anyway, free space is available. Some free space is available. We know that one now. Next, I want to create a new partition, N. P, V, N, N. Now, do you want to create new, when you are creating new partition, partition number is there, no? By default, 6. Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 completed. Next number is 6 by default. You don't want to create differently, like a 7, 8, like that. You can create it also. Otherwise, default is 6. Then put a 6. Otherwise, press enter also, no problem. Next. First sector. The first sector, don't touch the first sector until unless you know very well. Okay, so don't touch anything here in a first sector. Just press enter. Now, how much partition you want to create? How much partition you want to create? I want to create a 2 GB partition. I want to create a 2 GB partition. You want more? I'll create 4 GB partition for a difference. 4 GB partition I'm creating. Okay, so how to create? You can say 4 GB or plus 4G. Also, you can specify. You can see plus is showing here. It is size. Like you want to create MBs, M. Okay, 512 MB, 512 MB, M. Okay, 1 TB or 2 TB, 2T, like that. Okay, but you have to remember how much space actually left, based on that only we have to do it. Okay, so you have to calculate before how much space is there available, like that. Okay, 4 GB partition I'm going to create, guys. Next, created partition 6 is created. Next one, verify. 6 is created, 4 GB. Next, V. Yeah, still some more spaces are there. Next one is T. What is T? See, if you see this list, this is the boot related one, and this is the swap related partition. This is the Linux partitions, like that. Different type of partitions are there based on what type of data or what is the purpose of that one. So if you want to change it, you can change it. Actually, not required. Actually not required, but if you want to change, you can change it, because it's already Linux partition. It is already Linux partition. You want to change the partition type, you can press the T. Press T. It is asking which number. 6 number. Latest one is 6-1 only, right? L. L to know the partition type. Okay. Yeah, it is a little bit different type. It is showing. As the latest version, GPT type. So GPT will show you a different way. Linux partition. Yeah, this is a Linux type. Yeah, see, Linux system, Linux swap, Linux LVM. These three things I required. I'm searching for that one only. Linux system means regular Linux. Linux swap for a swap partition. We know that one already. Anybody can see in this list swap. Nineteen is a swap directly, right? So 19 is swap. Linux swap, Linux file system, Linux LVM. Because it's a new one, that's why I'm not able to figure it out directly. Linux. Yeah, here it is, 31. Okay, 31. What to do? So 19, 20, and up to 31. Then I will remove all other things. The T things. T2, change the file system, and when you press the L, then it is giving a big list. Out of this big list, what I want? 19, 20. Linux home is also there. Okay, we'll leave it like that, but I'm not using for anything. But important one is 3 only. I need only 3. I don't want all these things. But important one is Linux swap, Linux file system, LVM. Guys, depends upon 6th version, depends upon MBR type of disk, GPT type of disk, version of the Linux and kernel of the Linux, the numbers may change. Usually like 81, 82, 83, 8E, like that are there. Okay, 8E for LVM, sorry, 80E for LVM, 83 for a Linux file system, 82 for a swap file system. Okay, these are also there in Linux. Verify these things. Okay, verify these things. 8E, 83, 82. Okay, so already I told what are the important one: Linux swap, Linux file system, and LVM. Here we are using Linux file system in this one, in this scenario. So what is the number? 20. Okay, so I change the partition type to Linux file system to Linux file system only. Put a P, so it is still showing a Linux file system. You want to change it like I will show you change 6th one, and for example 19. So I change it from Linux file system to swap file system. How to change it back? P 6 Linux file system, which number? 20. Okay, I put a 31. What will happen? Now it is Linux swap. I'm changing it now, changing back to original one. P 6. Tell me the number for a Linux file system. What is the number? 19, 20, 31. Which one? Linux file system.
20.
Just 20. Okay. Linux file system. Make sure the Linux file system appear here. Now partitioning is completed, guys. Partition is completed. So what is the last one?
W,
very good. Save and exit type. But you will throw an error, no problem. Guys, remember, kernel manages the partition. Kernel should understand. Kernel is interact with your hardware, right? How many partitions are there? So kernel should get updated. What are the partitions you created? To get a kernel update, update partition information in kernel. To do that one, first one is restart. You restart your PC. Okay. Another one is, we don't restart every time, right? So another one is, we can put use a command called a part probe. Okay. Part probe, or we can use another command is partx. You see this one is also showing that command. See, k partx or a part probe. Okay. K partx or a part probe. 8 mean represent. Okay. So how to put these commands like this? Use a part probe. I usually use part probe only. Okay. You can type part probe or end. Or end. Both you can type. Okay. Slash dev slash SDEA. Or you can use, okay, slash dev slash SDA 6, because the name is 6th partition, right? SDA 6. So you have to use this one. So what is the meaning of this one? Update in kernel. You have to update in a kernel. Kernel will be used old table, new table will be used at next reboot or after you run part probe. PART PROBE. So you can type a part probe. It throws some error. It's only this CD-ROM related error. Otherwise, better put it 2 times because we are doing first time. So don't get errors in that one. Okay. Now what I done? Update in the kernel completed. Next step. Yeah, you guys are told. What is this? Next step.
Create double layer.
Format the disk. Partition. Otherwise, you can't put a data in it. So, what is the command we have to use? mkfs. Make file system. mkfs. Make file system like mkdir. Make file system mkfs. So the command is like this. Mkfs, if you search for a mkfs, there is a different type of formats are there, different way of giving a commands are there, but I am not doing like that. I want to give a very easiest way. mkfs.ext for slash dev slash sda 6. What is 6? My partition number, my newly created partition number, 6th one, sda 6. Yeah, done. Okay, done. So what command I given? mkfs dot ext for slash dev slash sda 6. Remember, 6 means this means which partition you are newly created. Format is done. df space hyphen h. Command is df space hyphen h. Look at this one. SDA 1, SDA 2, SDA 3, SDA 4. SDA 5 is FAP file system, so don't worry about it. But where is SDA 6 here? SDA 6 is there. Where is it located? Okay. So, if you see, it is not at mounted. SDA 1 mounted to slash boot slash EFI. SDA 2 slash boot. SDA 3 slash sda4 slash home, like that it is mounted. Okay, now next step, create a folder mount. So create a empty folder, guys. My pw is slash root. If anyone other if I create a folder here, it only accessed by root user. If I create a folder here in the current location, only root user can able to access. If I want to create a folder and any user can able to access, so where we should create a folder? I create a folder, but any user can able to access that folder.
Only slash.
Only slash, single slash, very good. Mkdir slash d disk 6. Just for understanding only, I put a d disk 6. Like it is a drive, like 6th one. Huh? So just for our understanding, you can put any name. I can put my name also, no problem. Okay, any name you can put it. But names are should be easy to understand, and we should understand by name what is the purpose of that name. Okay. So under slash we created. Next command is mount mount slash dev slash sda6. Okay, so don't worry. It's not throwing an error. It means command is correct. So I mounted it. How do you know mounted or not? So using a command called df space hyphen h. Df will show the disk and file mounting information. Okay, file mounting information. See, h represent human readable format. See, m, g, g, see, mbs, gbs. You can see the data directly. You want to see the data in MBs or KBs or GBs, then you have to change the letter here. You can put a K for a KBs, M for MBs, G for GBs. H means any format, so based on that GB or MB, it will show like directly. So, can you see this one? Guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So mounted or not? Mounted.
Yes,
4GB. 4GB mounted. So after mounting, put some data. Data some files. Touch slash dd this one and put up some file. Maybe ff one dot dot file. Ls space slash dd. So these files are created. So what is this LastPass flaw? Automatically it will create because it's a drive. If it is a folder, this won't create it. It is a drive, it is created. Files are created and files are stored in our drive only. Understand? I create a files in this particular folder. I create a files in this particular folder, but the files are created under this drive only. Under this drive only. Okay. So how to test it? How to test it? We'll unmount it. We'll remove the link. We remove the link from our folder to our directory. So we'll remove the link. So how to remove the link? Umount. Umount command for a unmount purpose. Umount command for a unmount purpose slash dd the 6 unmounted. Verify it is unmounted or not by checking it. See sda6. So this kind of stuff not showing here. Okay, it is not showing here. It means it is unmounted. Less no data. I put a data here. I put a data here. Why it is not showing data? Data stored in the disk, not in the folder. Understand? Data stored in the disk, not in the folder. Because of both are mounting. Mounting. Again. Guys, remember, you can mount the disk to any folder. Earlier I mounted to 6, you can mount it to 7, you mount it to 8, any empty folder you can mount it. Understand? You can mount it to any disk. No need to mount it to same disk, same folder again and again. No need. But we didn't create any other folder, so no problem. Otherwise, we will test it that way also. Mkdir slash and dd6. Some folder I created. Now mount slash dev slash sda6 slash dd6. Okay. See, is it mounted to dd6? ls space slash dd6. Data is there. Meaning is data in the directory. Sorry, data is in a drive, not in the directory. Data is in the drive, not in the directory. Directory is mounted to for our again. Directory is mounted. Why it is showing like this? Yeah, directory is mounted to our drive. So through directory we are able to put a data into the drive. Through this one only. Okay. Through this one only we are able to put a data in the drive. Okay. Through this one only we can able to access the data of the drive. And if you wherever you mounted from there, you can able to access. Only single mount we can able to do it. Okay. So with a single mount only we can able to do it. Guys, understand what are the steps we done?
So can we mount empty drive?
Yeah. Actually, I didn't get the question. I will tell once again. Otherwise, we'll see. Empty drive. You are asking about empty drive, right?
Yes.
Folder, the directory must be empty. First of all, the directory must be empty. Drive also empty drive. So whenever we connect, whenever you mounted this drive to this one, directory is empty. This is also empty. But before you mount, you must create a file system. This does not have any data. I created a data in it. The data went to directory. Okay, so without mounting, you cannot put a data in the drive. Without mounting, we can't put a data in the drive. Some old technology people also will tell what is MNT tab. MNT tab is a mount tab. To mount temporarily. Whatever it is. Okay. MNT tab. So guys, I think you are understand. What I want to do is that's it. What I will do, I will take a break, just 5 minutes or 10 minutes, take a break. 5 minutes is enough. Just relax. Next, after break, next part, we'll do it. We'll do it disk partition. Again, one more partition. This time, you tell me, I will do it. Okay? Next one is, we'll do disk partition for a swap also. Both, swap management, disk management. Next time, we'll get a SDE7. Okay? So, that is also, we'll do it as a disk partition. What we do done now? That is I will tell, you will tell. Next we'll do swap also. And of course we will see about what is a FS tab. What is a FS tab? And now only I will tell FS tab. First of all, okay, first of all, we'll go to the FS tab. FS tab, it means file system table. File system table. What is a file system table? It means, remember this, the mount we are done are temporary. Meaning is, when we boot, when at next boot or a reboot, the meaning is next boot means you shut down the PC, you start the PC, or you you reboot the PC. Both are same. Okay, next boot means next time. Now it is okay. Now for next time, next boot mount drives. Okay, the drives will unmounted. Okay, unmounted automatically. Unmounted. We have to mount manually again. So that is a problem. So what to do? For mount permanently, use FS tab. No. Put drive information in FS tab. FS tab is a file. FS tab is a file. Okay. The location of FS tab is /etc/FS tab only. Okay. Here you have to specify our drive information. Means, what is your drive? What is your folder? What is file system you are using? Okay. And how to do it. Next. One more command is there. BLK ID means talk ID. Why I got a laugh is, you know, when we learn first time about a BLK ID, so BLKID, we try to remember like BLKID. So type BLKID. It's not a BLKID, it's a BLK ID, lock ID. Okay, Linux is, once you jump into the Linux, you start swimming in it, just like you learn. Okay, get the block LED. Okay, yeah, so this is, I will explain, so don't worry. What is block ID and all? So I will explain that one. So once I explain, then only. So first we'll see what is FS tab. What is use of FS tab? Permanent mount. Okay, so we'll see how it is works. First command is ds-h. So what is ds-h? Check the mount information. One more command is there, that is called mount. Mount command is also will display the information. Just mount. Okay, this is easy. Tabular format. Guys, this is mount. How to unmount? Umount. You can use either folder name or drive name. So unmounted. Okay, unmounted. So what is the next one? Is FS tab. /etc/FS tab. /etc/FS tab. Very good. See, this is contained lot of information. Okay, series, FS tab, UUUID. Okay. Guys, I want to go end of the line. How to go end of the line?
G's.
Capital G. Okay. I went to end of the line, but I want next to line, insert mode with a next line. Small o. Okay. Yeah, you remember, guys. Very good. Very good. SDA 6. The first one is your drive. SDA 6. I will explain that UUID kind of stuff. Don't worry. Next one is where to mount. Where to mount. /dev/. DD 6. So I want to mount to this folder. Next one is your file system. ext4 file system. Put defaults. Guys, you no need to worry about this much. Give the tab space. This is thing. Just give a tab. /dev/sda. Sorry. Disk 6. Give the tab space. I given two tabs because this is a tab. Another tab I given. So it look good. ext4. Give the tab space. Are two tabs, no problem. You will understand. Defaults. Not always a defaults correct one, but there's a difference is there. 0, 0. Okay. So I will explain what is a 0, 0. So we'll see that. Save. Okay. Now it is not mounted. I'm mounting mount /dd 6. It is mounted automatically. See, when I given this command, I didn't specify which drive it is. When I given this command, it verify in my FS tab and it will check this information. It mounted automatically. Now even if I reboot the PC, it mount automatically. Even if I reboot the PC, it mount automatically. So what we done? This is the thing we done, but we missed something here. First verify mounting information and unmount from it and make sure unmounted. Okay. Then go to VI editor, FS tab. So here it is. What I done? /dev/. I enter a thing, right? Give the tab space. /dd 6. Given it another tab space. File system specified. Next, I put a defaults and 0, 0. Sorry, 0, 0. Okay. So I given. So then save and exit. Again, check it. Mounting. Put a some name, either this name or this one. Anything, one is enough. It verify in the FS tab. It mounts automatically. Guys, understand? What I done? Instead of mounting manually, I mounted with this command. Even if I reboot, when I next reboot also, it mounts automatically. Even if I unmount it, I reboot when I unmount it and reboot the PC, it mounts automatically. What is the meaning of this 0001? Meaning is like when I start the PC, check the disk. If disk is available, mount it. If it is not available, ignore it. Okay, check at the boot time only. 00 means check at a boot time. First 0 represent check at a boot time. Second represent thing available. If it is available, mount it. Not available, throw an error. Okay, problem. Okay, next one is 01 means check at a boot time. Check the information in the this. This is the kernel management only, guys. Kernel management, not a different one. When you start a PC, check the FS tab. What are the mentioned in the FS tab? It check it and mount those drives to the folders. Understand? It is a kernel management only. Kernel is not a something different one. It is first it verify drives and the folders, it mount it at a boot time only. So these represent, ignore it if the drive is not available, or ignore the folder is not available. Throw the error if drive or a folder is not available. That represent like this. Okay. But generally we are using like this. So I'm not going depth of it. Last point in this one is, guys, when I go to this tab, if you see UUIDs, UUIDs. What is this UUIDs instead of slash dev slash thing? Let's see. Slash dev slash SDA 1 or a slash dev slash SDA 6. These are logical type. Okay. Logical or a temporary type. It means every board names may changes. Sometimes it is SDA1, next would it become a SDA2. Okay, names and mounting may be changed. So in that cases you will get an error at boot time. When you start your PC, it verifies /dev/SDA6 is there or not. It, instead of SDA6, it's become SDB6 or maybe SDA5. Then problem will occur. Okay. So sometimes the names are different based on a different hard disk. 2-3 hard disks are there. Then different problems are there. So names are made changes because the logical or temporary names. Okay. For every boot, names may changes. But depends upon error at boot time will be occur. So what we will do, mount with a UUID. Okay. So what we say, use a UUID of UUID of disk drive. Means partition. UUID of disk partition. Okay. Of any disk partition, you have a UUID, so that is a disk partition. Okay. Use a UUID of partition in a FS tab. But easy to always use /etc/fs tab. Okay. So how to get a UUID? BLK. ID. Next command is ELK ID /dev/SDA6. Okay. Now we'll see BLK ID. What it is showing? All the disk. What it is showing? For all SDA1, SDA2, SDA3, SDA4, SDA5, SDA6, like that. Okay. For all the disk it is showing. Next, before that one, just get the information. 6 is already mounted. Umount /dis/unmounted BLK ID /dev/SDA6. Okay, BLK ID. /dev/SDA6. See here, this is the information. What I want information is this part only. Just I'm copying this one, guys. I'm copying this one. So I'll copy entirely. I will put it here. Okay. I put it here. This is I want. Okay. Next, VI editor. So you go to VI editor. Go to the last line. I want to delete this last line. What to do? Delete the line. Very good. Double D. Very good. Now, I'm pasting that line. See, I pasted. If you look at other things, the quotations are not there. So I'm removing quotations. Now, what I'm doing? Give the task space. Slash DD 696. Next, I'm giving file system ext4. Give the tab defaults 0 space 0. Okay, it may be little different from one to another one. Okay, it is given here only. It's given here. Given like this. This is given a space here. Not have space like this. So what I'm going to do is better to give a tab space or another tab space, no problem. This is single space only. Like this. Adjust it. Escape colon WQ. Not mounted, right? So I'm mounting manually just for understanding working on that. Okay. So it is mounted. If I unmounted, for example, if I unmounted, what to do? If I unmounted and I rebooted my PC and it mount automatically without any errors. So that is a keep in mind. So what I'm going to do is, here it is. What I done, I went to VI slash etc slash FS tab. Okay. The first one is, I put this one, Control C. I added this line in the bottom of FS tab. So what is the FS tab purpose? So every next board, what are we specified? What are we specified in the FS tab? But at the time of boot time only, it mounts. At the time of boot time only, it mounts automatically. Okay, you no need to mount the disk every time. So that every manually, no need to mount it. So this is complete mounting information. Just we'll go from the starting, guys. So we'll see once again. Disk management. So we use the fdisk command to disk management kind of stuff. So verify how many disks are there, what are their partitions are available. Next, go to the disk using fdisk slash dev slash sda. And there's a few things we have to follow the sequence. First, you have to press N. Sorry, first pre for a print the partition table. Next, V for verify the partition table if partition thing is available. N for a new partition. So create a new partition with a number and all. Okay, next one is change the partition type. Which partition type you want it, like a Linux file system, swap or LVM type. These three things, file systems are very important. So depends upon your disk type or like this. We are using here as a GPT type. Okay. Next, once you done a W, once you done a save, after that one, you have to put a in a normal terminal part probe. So what is a part probe? Update the partition table information in kernel. Part probe automatically update any your hardware information in kernel automatically. Okay. So to update your partition table into kernel, so we are using a command called a part probe. You can use part probe or part probe like your disk name or a disk partition name also. Okay. Next, we have to format the your disk using a MKFS makefile system. So I'm giving simple command is like this. There are a lot of different way to give the command, but I given a very simple way. MKFS.ext4 is a file system, ext4. Okay, I formatted it. Once the format is done, I create an empty folder and I mounted it. Okay, then I create a files in the folder and verify whether it is there in the mount or not by unmounting it. How to unmount the file? How to unmount it? Umount is a command. Umount is for a unmount. ds space -h for a verifying mounting information. Verifying mounting information. FS tab. So whenever we mount manually, it is a temporary type mount only, manual mount only. Whenever you reboot the PC automatically, it is unmounted. So you have to mount the drives manually again. So you want to mount permanently, like every next boot, automatically it mounts. At the boot time only, drives will be mounted. What we need? We need a FS tab. Specify the things in your FS tab. So like this. Okay, so specify your drive information in the FS tab. So whenever you restart your PC, whenever you start your Linux PC, it verifies FS tab and mount these drives. Okay, but problem is these drive names logical means if I add an extra hard disk or a hard disk names will be changes from SDA1 to SDV1, SDC. Like that, names will be changes depends upon the system to depends upon the system and the drives disk in the system. So names are changes and it will get confused. So then there is a problem may occurs. So what it will happens like that. Okay. So what we do? So to avoid this confusion with the logical names or a temporary names, we are using a directly block IDs. This is the block ID. Is generated by the block ID command. Okay, so I got the block ID of this thing, SDA6. This is a UUID like this. So in my FS tab, I specified my UUID and remaining are same. So instead of very simple, instead of /dev/SDA6. Instead of this partition name, I am specify unique ID. Only that one is. Now what happened? When you reboot, if you add a more hard disk, more partitions, no problem, no confusion, no name kind of stuff. Okay. Even the names are different, no problem, because this is a unique ID for each partition. Unique ID for each partitions are unique IDs. So no problem. So it will won't throw any error. So this is it. This is about your disk partition. So next, only once I will show you. You will do it like a swap and disk partitions after a small break, like take a 5 minutes break.